If you have some secrets in your app that you want to keep secret, then maybe it's time to add biometrics to your .NET MAUI app. Let's find out how to do that in this video. Almost all devices these days have some form of biometric verification. You can use your fingerprint to unlock your device or your face. At least that's if you're using iOS and Android, mostly on Windows. There's some stuff as well. But the plugin that I'm about to show you makes it super, super easy to also add that biometric verification to your .NET MAUI app, which makes it possible for you to lock sensitive data behind that biometric verification. So that is really cool. But this plugin only supports iOS and Android right now. Maybe you're a Windows wizard because it's all open source. And you can add the Windows verification here as well. I think you can use Windows Hello and all that kind of cool stuff. But for now, for this video, I'm focusing on iOS and Android and showing you how to add this to your .NET MAUI application so you can apply that to your application as well. Now, before we dive into the code, let me answer this one question that comes up from time to time, which is, can I access the data of the fingerprint of the face that is used for the biometric verification? And the answer is very simple. That is no, absolutely not, which is a good thing because that is very privacy sensitive information, right? If you get that, you can do all kinds of crazy things like identity theft and whatnot. So that is something that you do not want to do. The way these APIs work is that the OS, the operating system, iOS, Android, Windows, I hope all the operating systems are doing that the same way, will record that information, right? That will record the fingerprint. It will record data about the face. It will lock that securely inside of the device, encrypted. You cannot reach it. And the only thing the API does is say, hey, you want to verify if this person is, you know, on this device, registered as a face, as a fingerprint, and you can verify that with the information that is locked on the operating system, and it will only tell you, like, yes, this person is authorized to unlock this phone, or no, this person does not belong to this phone or this device, and you cannot go through. That is the only thing the API kind of like does. So with that, let's just dive into my screen share and see how easy it is to implement this inside of your .NET MAUI application. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. I just created a new .NET MAUI project right here, which you can see the welcome screen is here. The project, which I made no changes to as of now, is on the right in the Solution Explorer. And the first thing that we want to do is install this NuGet, this plugin, this project. Also, go check out the GitHub repository. Consider contributing, maybe sponsoring, at least star the repository, right? That's always to show the support to the author of this plugin who is working hard to make this all possible for us. So I'm going to go to the project, right-click, and do Manage NuGet Packages. Of course, everything you see here, you can also do in VS Code or any other editor of your liking. And here in the Browse, we're going to search for Plugin.Maui.Biometric. And what is really, really cool is that the author of this plugin has used my plugin repository template, if you will, which I made a video about as well, which allows you to create your own .NET MAUI plugins. So definitely go check that out as well. It's linked down below in the video description, and I'll link it at the end of the video, so make sure to stick around. So you're going to find this one, plugin.maui.biometric. We can install that. Just click on it, click install, and it will install all the dependencies that we need. As per usual for Android, that is a lot. So just apply. You're going to have to read like all the license agreements here. I'm sure that you'll do that. I did it just before this video, so I can agree to all of those. And that will install the plugin here in my project. It will show the little check mark here in a little bit when it's got it restored. There we go. And now I have it installed. You don't need to do any kind of like initialization. That is custom for a lot of the plugins, but this is not really a visual control. So you don't really need to do that here. So now you can just start using it basically. Well, almost. We need to set up some permissions, right? Because this, again, this is sensitive privacy stuff. So we always need permissions for that. So let's go into the platforms folder for Android. I'm going to show you mostly Android for now, but I also tested it on iOS. So the same code should work on iOS just fine. And go into the Android manifest. Actually, I want to show the source. So let's go to open with. And then I'm going to select the XML text editor so I can just edit the source from this thing. And I'm going to add a new permission right here. I'm just going to copy this line. And I'm going to add here the use biometric. metric. There we are. And now it knows, like, hey, the permissions for the biometric is here. It's going to show that in the App Store listing, all kind of stuff. So we're good to go here. Now for iOS, we need to do the same thing. For iOS, we can go into the info p list. Also, let me open this with the XML editor right here. And I'm going to copy a little key from here off the side so I don't have to do all this typing. And this actually comes from like the example that is on the repository for this plugin. But the key that you need is this one. And this talks about the face ID, right? Because face ID is now what is on most iOS devices, but it also still has the fingerprint. And actually for the fingerprint, you don't need this permission. So that's kind of odd, right? It doesn't really trigger this. So this is only used for face ID, but you need to have this in here. But the plugin will also work for touch ID. Very important to know, it will also work for that. Here you need to have a little description like, hey, the need your face to unlock, not really descriptive. You want to make sure to have something in here why you're actually using this, right? To ensure your user like, hey, I'm not doing anything funny here. This is just something that I need. Okay, so with that in place, we're good to write some code. I'm going to show the close this getting started page. Yes, that's fine. And close these platforms folder right here. And there is two ways to use this, kind of like how I structured this plugin for everyone. And that's cool if you're using this kind of like plugin repository template. Now all the plugins are kind of like structured the same way. So you can use them the same way. So you can use it with dependency injection if that's what you want. So you can say I guess you can add this as a singleton. That would make sense. You can do iBiometric. The author of this plugin has provided a interface that you can use for this. And then you can register the biometric. I need to add the right using in here. Oh, it actually did that. So I'm going to have to add the biometric authentication service. There it is. IntelliSense was confused for a moment. And we can do the default one, right? So we have that. And now it's registered and we can just use that with dependency injection inside of our .NET MAUI application. But if you just want to use the static instance, you can just use this biometric authentication service.default as well. Let me just keep this in here. Use with dependency injection, just so you know that how to get started with this. And now what you can do is go into your main page. Actually, you have to register your main page there as well. I can say here, iBiometric and biometric, and you can call all the things on that, right? So you have this dependency injection thing going on. Now, here in the on counter clicked, I'm going to use the static implementation for this. So I'm just going to do this. And actually, let's do this. Let's keep this in place. This is just the default.NET MAUI template, right? Just the little button that increments, but it's only going to increment whenever we successfully authenticate to this biometric thing, right? So let's just do that. And I can do var result. So you kind of like have to catch the result of the authentication action, obviously. And you can actually do a couple of things with this API, namely two, which is get authentication status. So you can kind of like get the status of, hey, the hardware status. I didn't test this out fully, but I think this only kind of like works for Android mostly, but I'm not sure. Maybe it will give you some information on iOS as well. But the most important one is the authenticate async, right? So that's just going to trigger the authentication and will give you the result. So let's just do that. And with that, we have to specify a authentication request. So we're just going to do new authentication request, and that has a bunch of options for us to use. And the other thing that it has is a cancellation token, which is really, really cool. So let me know if you want to know more about cancellation tokens in the comments, because I will explain a little bit more and make a dedicated video to that maybe. But cancellation tokens allows you to kind of like cancel this action programmatically. So maybe there's a timeout in your code because this is happening async, right? And you're like, okay, I've waited 5 seconds. Apparently this user does not want to increment the button anymore. I'm just going to say cancellation token.cancel, and it's going to go away with this authentication result. It's going to say, hey, it timed out, you cannot authenticate anymore. So that's kind of like what you can do with a cancellation token, right? Does that make sense? Let me know down in the comments if you want to see a video. If you do not want to use that functionality, you can just say, hey, cancellation token.none. There's no cancellation token here. There's no way to programmatically cancel it. The only way to cancel it is if the user is going to do that manually from the application. So there we have that. Now there's a couple of things in this authentication request that you want to set. There is the title, and this is also somewhat specific per platform. So the title is going to show, I think you also have a subtitle, only going to show on Android. On iOS, it's only going to show the title whenever you're using Touch ID. So make sure that you test all the scenarios here and make sure that it works for all the scenarios, because there is some weirdness going on here. And there's also, what was it again? Negative text. So that's kind of like your cancel button, I think. And also this only works on Android, but very important, you need to add it for Android and it cannot be empty, right? So if you don't have this, Android is going to blow up. It's going to throw an exception. It's not going to work. So you have to provide something here like cancel authentication, something like that. We'll see that show up in Android in a little bit. You know where it's going to be placed, although it might be different per Android version as well, right? So there's all that in play as well. That's the fun of cross-platform development. There you are. So please authenticate to increment. I'm not sure if this is going to show all the text here, but here we are. And we need to await this, right? Because it's an async one, so we need to do that. Async void, and there we go. So now we can check the result if result dot status authentication type. What is it? Is the status, I think, is yes. So here we are. Biometric response status failure and success. So depending on what you want to do, you can check the result here. You can do the success. We want to do the success one. And whenever it is a success, we're actually going to do the rest, right? We're actually going to increment. Otherwise, we're going to do nothing. I could say else, obviously. You can probably also check like, hey, maybe you want to, so this is an important one. You might want to check like the result dot error message that's there. So that's kind of like how I found out that you need to set this negative text. I didn't do that. And then in the result dot error message, there was like, hey, you need to set this thing, right? So you probably also want to include that for proper error handling to see if this is not null or empty or something like that, and see what the error is and deal with that in some way or form. But here I'm going to say await display alert. Nope. Couldn't authenticate. Well, would then authenticate like that and say, okay, right? So there's that, just a little message to show you the different paths here. Okay, I think with that in place, we can just start running our application and we have biometric security in place for our application. Now, this is of course a really silly thing, right? Like we're going to increment or not, but you could use this for your full pages. At some point I built an app which had to do with like accountancy, that kind of stuff. And they wanted to, the pattern that you kind of like see happening is that you will implement some kind of PIN code, right? That's something that you see happen a lot. You can lock this app with a PIN code. And then as a layer on top of that, you can say, hey, I want to add this biometric verification to make that a little bit easier for my user. So they don't have to tap all these numbers. They can just keep looking at the screen in for iOS and it will unlock automatically. And how that works is kind of like you record the PIN code, you secure that, you save that in secure storage. And then the only thing whenever you pull it out is for the biometric thing, you fill it in automatically and then you have made it easier for your user to work with your app. So you can use that to launch your full app, to do that on the first page. And whenever they do not verify, they cannot enter the application, or you can lock just one page or one functionality behind this thing. It is totally up to you. While I was talking, the app has been built for Android. It's going to deploy here on the emulator. And what is kind of like fun here is that you can actually do this on the emulator. Obviously, you also want to test this on a physical device, which is even more fun because you can then actually see it in action. But you can also do this on the emulator. So if I move this a little bit to the left, you have these three dots here with this menu, and you then get this whole control panel for the simulator. And one of which is the fingerprint right here. And you can enroll multiple fingers. There's 10, obviously, so you can do that and you can touch the sensor for all of this. Now, I did not set this up before, so what's going to happen now? It's actually going to fail, right? Couldn't authenticate. Nope, because I did not set up any authentication on the device, so it doesn't have anything to compare with. So that is why it's failing right now. So if I close this one for now and I go into the settings, And this kind of like, it works in a different way for iOS, but iOS has the same capability, but it's under like the top menu for the iOS simulator. You will figure it out, I'm sure. For Android, it's a little bit more complicated because you have to actually set it up in the emulator, but for iOS, this functionality is there as well. If you can't figure it out, let me know down in the comments and I'll show you. So here we have, you can search, and I'm going to search for fingerprint. It will show up automatically, and you will see that there is always a fallback option. So whenever I want to configure this fingerprint for this device, you also have to set a password or a PIN code. So let me just do that. Tap to set up. I want to set up the fingerprint pattern phase. Let me do a PIN. PIN phase fingerprint. You can do all the things here. Let me just set this to 1, 2, 3, 4. Of course, you want to do something more secure, but I'm just going to do this for now because this is a demo. I can get away with anything. So we have that. Lock screen, what do you want to show? Notifications, that's fine. And here, I can now say face unlock. I don't think you could do face unlock with the emulator, so you will have to use a physical device for that. But I can use pixel imprint, which is the name for the fingerprints right here. And the way this works is kind of funny. I can now say I agree to all the things here and touch the sensor, which is actually something I can trigger right here. So I'm going to do finger one, touch sensor, touch sensor, touch sensor, kind of like mimics that I have to do it a couple of times, right? And now it's added. It is added to my device. So here we go. You can see one finger is added. So we've kind of like emulated that we actually set this up for this device right now. And that is pretty amazing. And if I go back to my application, I have it here, my little MAUI biometric sample, which you can find on GitHub. The link is down below in the video description. And when I try to trigger this again, it will actually show me the authentication thingy right here. And it will say like, hey, oh, you can see the title scrolling here. You can have to authenticate to increment, right? Touch the fingerprint sensor, which I can do by clicking right here. Or I have that cancel authentication right here, right? So that's the negative text that was set here. So if I do that, it's going to go to this path and again say, hey, I couldn't authenticate. But I can do it again and actually touch the sensor right here. And now it will go through and you can see it actually increments and it actually follows the happy path and it will allow me to do this thing that is behind the biometric verification. So that is super really cool. And that is how easy it is to implement this bio verification inside of your .NET MAUI app. There are a couple of more options in this plugin that will set you the ability to fall back to the actual password and the PIN whenever the verification fails. So you can also kind of like disable that. So you only allow biometric verification. I'm not sure if that's a good idea because, you know, if someone loses a finger, I hope not. But if that happens, then that person will need some kind of fallback, right? So the PIN code that is set on the device is still very secure, but always something can happen. Maybe a more optimistic scenario would be that the sensor breaks, right? And you will have the PIN code to actually have that fallback scenario. But you have the option to kind of like not allow that. There is some more text options to set the subtitle, to add some more description to the dialogues right here. And of course, then there is the iOS version of this, which will work with the exact same code that you have seen here as well. I hope this video was useful to you. Let me know how you're going to apply that biometric security to your .NET MAUI application, what other videos you want to see, and maybe you are that potential new .NET MAUI plugin author. Check out the video that I mentioned earlier right here on that where I walk you through building your first .NET MAUI plugin yourself, and I'll see you for that one.